Thanks, Jordan. A new Missouri law allows counties to approve property tax breaks for senior citizens. St. Charles County could be become the first in the St. Louis region to approve this kind of tax break.
At the Bar of Dues, Lars Simon is live in St. Charles this morning with a look at how soon this legislation could be approved and who qualifies. Good morning to you, Laura.
Good morning to you, Blair and John. The St. Charles County Council could approve this bill as soon as today. And if it passes, you would essentially need to be 62 years of age or older by January of next year. And you would also need to, of course, live here in St. Charles County. But St. Charles County would essentially be the first county in the region to adopt this property tax freeze for seniors. The bill being voted on by the St. Charles County Council would localize the measure passed by the Missouri legislature earlier this year. Governor Mike Parson signed it into law, and under the new law, individual counties are allowed to freeze property tax rates on the primary homes of senior citizens, and it would create a tax credit to offset the cost of their property taxes. The proposed legislation also ends state taxes on Social Security benefits starting in 2020. The tax freeze would also apply to all taxing jurisdictions located within St. Charles County. So think things like school and fire districts, and not just to the portion of a property tax bill that goes to the county itself. About 2% of the total property tax goes to the county for the dedicated road and bridge fund and dispatch and alarm fund. We do expect to hear from County Executive Steve Ellman about the possible impacts of this bill before it goes before the council tonight for a vote. But he'll be explaining around 6:45 tonight, just before that meeting, how the bill could affect senior property taxes and any possible court challenges with this. The county council is scheduled to make their final vote at a meeting that is set here at the executive building located on North 3rd Street at 7 tonight. And if this does pass, it would go into effect next year. And keep in mind, if you do have any outstanding balances on property taxes from previous years, you would still need to pay that money. Reporting live here in St. Charles this morning, I'm Laura Simon.